in case of human being, there is coordination of various organic systems. Say for example, why there is sense of hunger. In our brain, there is center which measures glucose level in the blood. I'm giving in very simplified manner. This center measures glucose level in the blood. As glucose level falls down, this center becomes activated and starts sending message that there is sense of hunger. Say for example, if you are studying out something and glucose level decreases, then you may get message that sense, yes, some hunger feeling is there. But still you continue to study, then slowly this glucose level will fall down and center become more and more activated. That is the basic thing. That is the demand of food by our body. Many people are having habit that they are consuming some tea or coffee when they are hungry, and then the sense of hunger is lost out. The reason is that when we are consuming tea or coffee which is having sugar, then in our body the glucose level, as you are aware, sugar is disaccharide which is converted into monosaccharide in our body, and it absorbs in blood. As a level, glucose level increases, hunger center stop functioning, and that's why we are having now no sense of hunger by consuming this. That means actually our digestive system is prepared for getting food, but just by adding out cup of tea or coffee, we are suppressing out that and our sense of hunger is lost. Sometimes people become angry. In our body, glucose, extra glucose in the blood is converted into a polymer that is called as glycogen, and that is stored in liver. So glucose is stored in form of glycogen in the liver. Whereas on requirement, this glycogen is converted into glucose and released in blood. That is the process. There is one hormone secreted by a gland that is called as adrenal gland. That is having name as adrenaline. This gland is present on kidney. When person become angry, person is having some fear, suddenly fear is there, suddenly he become angry, then immediate action is that adrenaline is secreted by adrenal gland. This adrenaline on secretion is having action on liver, where glucose is converted into glycogen and stored out. It starts secreting out glucose. That means glycogen is converted into glucose and it releases in blood. As a result, we are having rise in glucose level in blood, and then again sense of hunger is lost out. That's why you must have noticed that when we are observing television or some program, movie, and we are consuming food, it is not that good. Because depending upon your emotions, the hormones are secreted in our body, and then sense of hunger may be having some plus or minus. Many times I like that various British systems are not perfect, especially personal hygienic values of this British system are not that good, but their food habit, I must appreciate, they are really good. According to that system, sweet dish is consumed after the lunch or dinner. In Indian system, we are consuming sweet while our meal only. Actually, what happened exactly, that suppose you are consuming some sweet along with your meal, then automatically in blood sugar level rises and then sense of hunger lost out, and we are having actually earlier the sense of fulfillment, and that's why it is recommended that while having meal, you should not consume sweet part at beginning. We have to keep it at end, and at end we have to consume that. So this way there is sense of hunger. So sense of hunger is developed first in our brain, but not only that, glucose level is important. certain other characters are also important. By hearing some sound, we may connect, our brain may connect that sound with certain part of food. Certain smells, pleasant odor, they may also rise your sense of hunger. Even thinking of food is also rising sense of hunger. And like that, all other factors are also important. So, basically, first thing, before nutrition, there should be sense of hunger. Then only person can think of this. You are aware that many times during certain surgeries or like that, person is hospitalized. And then we are saying he is on saline. Actually, it is not saline. It is actually, we have to say IV fluid. That IV fluid that is having saline, that means salt water plus dextrose. Dextrose is supposed to be form of glucose. Glucose solution is there. It is supplied in directly blood, and that's why if the person is there on that dextrose solution, then that person may not have sense of hunger, because glucose level in blood is maintained and sense of hunger is lost. Even in diabetic patient also, the same thing is there, because usually glucose level is high and therefore we are having problem with diabetic person, that sense of hunger is not that level in case of diabetic person. So this is the way. First there is sense of hunger, then availability of food. It is not always that on your sense of hunger you should have availability of food or like food like that. Then there is coordination between your eyes. Then olfactory, that means smell of, sense of smell, taste, all that. That's why when we are going in hotel, you are having that well decorated dish they are showing you. That decoration may increase your liking to that food. Smell, that is also playing another role. In case of other animals, where olfactory sense is to great extent, they are smelling out first and then start consuming out. Like cat, dog, you must have observed that they are taking first smell and then start consuming food. In case of human being, our this sense is not that developed, but little bit develop is there, and good smell may increase your appetite. Then there is coordination, that first food enters in buccal chamber, that we are consuming food inside, where it is in between 28 or 32 or whatever number of teeth are present in your mouth, that is food is there, which is physically or say mechanically we are grinding out that and converting into fine particles. Say for example, if you are consuming out hard substance, like directly you can consume wheat, then it is softened in our mouth with help of saliva. Here salivary glands are present and they are secreting out saliva. Saliva is also having one enzyme. Now you are aware of the word enzyme. Enzyme means what? A chemical which triggers out chemical reaction. So some enzymes are there. It is called as ptyalin. Name of enzyme is ptyalin. But for my sake of convenience, I should say that don't say ptyalin. We have to pronounce p-tyalin. Why? Because in the spelling p is there. And so you have to keep in mind the enzyme secreted there, that is called as ptyalin, but pronounce it something like that, p-tyalin. Or this is called as salivary amylase. Saliva is alkaline in nature. So when we are consuming something, that food is made alkaline first in your buccal chamber. Saliva is having some sort of soapy touch. So saliva is softening out that food, and then it is finally crushed down in your mouth, and then it is converted into small ball with fine particle size. It is called as bolus. Then it enters in our throat region. We are calling this as a tube. Small tube is there, that is called as esophagus. Many times it is pronounced as esophagus also. So it is esophagus. Through esophagus, it enters in stomach. Now here, I have to show a sort of drawing here. So from mouth, this is neck region. Then suppose person is something like this, then this is his chest region. It pass out through entire chest, because chest region is there for lungs and heart. And then it enters here through a diaphragm. The diaphragm is there between chest and stomach. And then there is part, we are calling this as stomach. So esophagus transfers food from buccal chamber to stomach. Now here in stomach there are valves between esophagus and stomach, and stomach is these valves are not allowing food to go again in the esophagus. Valve is there to direct out something. So food is directed from esophagus to stomach. But the question is that how food, here I am saying this is the bolus, how this much size bolus is passed out through this small tube? This is just because of gravity. If that is the so, then astronauts, they should not able to eat food, because the moment they are getting food inside, the food will stick here only, because in space shuttle gravitational force is not there, and therefore that is applicable, it is not there, therefore food should remain here, it should not come down. A person is sleeping and consuming something, then food should not go down, it should be there only. But practically food is going down. The reason is that this bolus now enters here. This esophagus is having muscular outlet, and these muscles are pressing out this food into stomach. This action is called as peristalsis. With peristalsis, the bolus is transferred from mouth to stomach. Now when we are having sense of hunger, in stomach preparation start out. The stomach is having three layers here. I am not going into that detail now, which is secreting, there are gastric glands on the last inner layer. These gastric glands are starting out secretion of juice that is called as gastric juice. The first part of gastric juice is mucus layer. Mucus means some sticky, slippery liquid is there. So that layer is secreted. Why? Because the enzyme should not have action on stomach. So this way first gastric juice, that first component of gastric juice is mucus substance. That mucus substance is secreted here. Then hydrochloric acid is secreted. Very strong hydrochloric acid is present here in stomach. So hydrochloric acid is secreted. And then other part of gastric juice, like enzymes, like pepsinogen, trypsinogen, these are secreted here. The food till that start entering over here. The function of hydrochloric acid is, number one, food is made acidified. Number two, any living organism is entering there, then it should die. So you may ask, how living organism can enter there? So for example, certain cattle, you are aware that they are consuming raw grass, and on that grass some insects may be there. So if at all these ways insects or like that living organisms are entering, if you are talking of frog, then also digestive system is similar, where the insect is directly taken into stomach. It is live only, so that should be killed out. For that purpose HCl is there. Then the important thing, that certain reactions are pH sensitive, that means acidity or basicity sensitive. So pepsinogen, trypsinogen, all these enzymes, they are kept in acidic medium, so they are inactive. Only thing that they are mixed out here in stomach. So role of stomach, number one, food is taken in, it is acidified. Here food is basic in nature, that food is converted into acid and it is acidified in the stomach. For food, depending upon the nature of food, 3 to 6 hours period food is there in the stomach. After 3 to 6 hours, that means complete mixing, here also mixing is there. This is something muscular part which mix out the food inside thoroughly with these enzymes and all. already food is softened out, that is there in stomach, that is finally mixed with this type of enzymes, where pepsinogen is converted into a substance that is called as pepsin. Trypsinogen is converted into substance that is called as trypsin. And now I have to talk of another gland in human body. Here I am showing in red color, my drawing is not that perfect, but you can just imagine a huge gland here. This is the largest gland in our body, that is called as liver. In English, you are aware there are figure of speeches. In that figure of speech, we have pun. In that pun, one example is given, is life worth living? And answer is given, it depends upon liver. It is really, it depends upon liver. Largest gland, multi-purpose organ in our body, that is liver. In our blood, red blood corpuscles are there, RBC. The main role of RBC is to transfer oxygen from lungs to various organs. RBCs are consisting of a compound protein that is hemoglobin. RBCs are having average life of 100 days. Usually 90 to 120 days is period we are considering here, 100 days as average life. On completion of their life, they are taken to spleen. One organ is there on intestine in the stomach part, that is called as spleen. So this liver, RBCs are taken to spleen. In spleen, whatever useful material is taken out from that dead RBCs, and remaining material is taken to liver. So this way, from spleen, the scrap material from RBCs, which is of now no use, that is taken to liver. In liver, it is converted into a proteinous substance. Actually, it is made up of protein only. Nitrogen is present. A yellow color substance that is called as bile juice. It is very intense yellow in nature, color, and then it is stored temporarily in a sac-like organ which is called as gallbladder. So here I am showing something, gallbladder over here. So this is liver, this is gallbladder. Those who are consuming non-veg and observing that, you can observe this, a green color bag is appearing on the liver. Actually, it is not green color. The bag is having color as blue, intense blue color is there. But inside that, intense yellow color liquid is there, and therefore color appear to be green. Then there is organ that is called as pancreas. Pancreas is secreting out hormone that is called as pancreatic amylase, pancreatic lipase. All these things simply we are calling as pancreatic juice. Pancreas is secreting out these enzymes. Apart from that, pancreas is having small part, we are calling this as islets of Langerhans. Don't pronounce islet of Langerhans, we have to pronounce as islets of Langerhans. And they are secreting out enzyme, hormone that is called as insulin. So I am revising. Pancreas is consisting of islets of Langerhans which secretes insulin. Insulin converts glucose into glycogen. In previous part we discussed that adrenaline converts glycogen into glucose, whereas insulin converts glucose into glycogen. Now pancreas is secreting out a juice that is called as pancreatic juice. So at a time pancreas is carrying out two different functions. One is secretion of pancreatic juice, another one is through islets of Langerhans, hormones are produced. Now, gallbladder is giving duct that enters to pancreas, and it enters in first part of stomach. Here onwards I should show intestine. The first part of intestine, that is called as a duct, duodenopancreatic duct. This duodenopancreatic duct will enter open here. Now, already we are aware that bile juice is produced from waste material only. That material is to be, material is required to throw only. It is not having any other use. We have to throw that material outside of the body. But see the utility that it is proteinous waste, so it is a highly alkaline in nature. Instead of throwing directly outside the body, it is taken to gallbladder, it is stored there, and it is sent to duodenum, where the food coming out from stomach is highly acidic, which is immediately converted. It is neutralized first by this bile juice and then converted into alkaline in nature. If bile juice, instead of entering in duodenum, start entering in the bloodstream, then we are calling this condition as jaundice. A person become yellow in color. All this bile juice start entering in the bloodstream. This is happening. Now here, it is entering. We are considering only normal case. It enters in the duodenum and then it pass out through intestine. Now already food is mixed thoroughly with various enzymes. Inside the intestine, so we are calling this as small intestine. Small intestine is a part of digestive system which is very, very long. A small channel is there, but lengthwise, in case of human being, it is around 18 feet in the length. It is coiled here inside. I am not able to show. It is coiled inside. And then, food start passing out through that, where digestion process begins. Already you are aware that pancreatic amylase is mixed out here, which converts carbohydrates to glucose. Then lipase is there. As bile juice is now entered here, the fat is converted into emulsion and then it is absorbed with help of this lipase and all that enzymes. Then pepsin is there. That pepsin is converted into, as we discussed, that it is converted from pepsinogen. This pepsin is digesting out protein. It is converted into amino acids, and amino acids are absorbed by intestine. Like that, things are achieved. So intestine is basically there, that food which is digested, that is absorbed here. And then here, throughout this coil, food is moving out. Whatever the digested part is there, that is absorbed. And then a last part here, that is of large intestine, which is something like this here. It is coming out through this tract. In large intestine, food is coming out where almost all digested part is absorbed. Undigested material with water, and whatever the enzymes are there, that liquid that is coming to large intestine, where in large intestine water is absorbed and food is stored here. That food means what? Now this is waste. You are aware that cellulose is not digested in human digestive system. So it is coming as fiber, but it is required so that motion is there. It is temporarily stored here and then it is ejected. When we are calling this as process ejection. I am revising again. The digestion or nutrition, actually nutrition is considered into different steps. First one is digestion, which begins with mouth, stomach and intestine. In intestine, a next stage is there, that digested food is absorbed. So second stage is absorption. Third stage, that absorbed food is converted into body part. Say for example, I discuss about insulin. Insulin is converting out glucose into glycogen. So that means it is converted into body part. Amino acids are absorbed and it is converted into required protein. So it is also assimilation. Various minerals are absorbed and utilized for day-to-day body function. Water is absorbed and used to body function. It is all assimilation. And then undigested food is thrown away. This is called as ejection. So this is about digestion process in human. Digestion is one part, but another part is also there, that is proper nutrition. In case of India, if I am talking, then proper nutrition, we have to consider the ideal Indian food is consisting of all these required things. See, our adequate food, ideal food is giving you adequate important thing. So for example, we have a habit of consuming some raw material. That is also required so that cellulose can enter to greater extent. Then potassium salt and certain vitamins, say for example C vitamin. C vitamin is highly unstable. On heating, C vitamin is converted into some other substance which is not considered as C vitamin. And so its nutritional value is not there. Suppose you are using lemon, then lemon is very good source of C vitamin. But if you are cutting out lemon and keeping it for a long time, then its C vitamin amount decreases. That means nutritional value decreases. Like that, if you are heating out, then also C vitamin value decreases. Now here, we have to consider the food which will give us adequate thing, daily required thing. But these required things are not same for all people. Say for example, many people are having work. They are saying it is work, but practically speaking, these people are sitting in the chair and they are using laptop, computer, mobile, telephone and carrying out entire day work where energy requirement is not that high. A person is making some house, constructing some house, and for that purpose practically transferring bricks from one place to another, his energy requirements are very high. So depending upon your job, our food requirements are there. In case of female, iron deficiency is a common problem observed in India. This is there because of lack of knowledge and some faulty nutritional pattern is adopted. So when person is consuming food, person should consider that what is our body requirement and what food we have to take. Say for example, protein amount should be there. Proteins are required. Proteins are our body building material. The role of protein, that is our body is entirely made up of proteins. Then various enzymes, when I am talking of enzymes, enzymes are also made up of proteins only. Hormones like insulin made up of proteins, hemoglobin, and all these things are made up of proteins. So metabolic activity also proteins are required. So these are important role of protein. But apart from that, on requirement of energy, proteins can be burnt, means oxidized, to get energy. So another important role of protein is to get energy. But this is in case of emergency only, not always. Fat is actually reserve food of our body. Whereas certain vitamins are not water soluble. These vitamins are fat soluble. Then you are aware that synovial fluid is there. That means between joints. Suppose I am talking of this shoulder joint, that humerus bone is attached to pectoral girdle through that some cavity. Then there is a joint that is called as synovial joint, where synovial fluid is there. This is also having good amount of fat. Greasing like action is there, that means lubricants are used. So like that, fat is having important role in body. Then you are aware that cell membrane, in cell membrane also fat is required. So it is not that one should never consume fat. Fat is also required by body, but not to excess. So this is protein's role. Then fat is used as reserve food. And when energy requirements are more, then along with glucose, fat is also burnt out to give energy. That's why suppose you are walking with a friend slowly, then only glucose is consumed. But if you are walking vigorously or climbing on hill, then along with glucose, fat body start burning out. So additional energy is supplied by fat. Glucose is predominantly used as a source of energy. Our all metabolic activities require energy, and that energy is provided with help of burning out of glucose. Vitamins are required to maintain certain organs, certain systems in our body. Vitamins are proteins only, but they are required in very small amount. But their presence is really important. That's why they are called as vital amines. In short, we are calling it as vitamins. Certain vitamin deficiency may lead to certain problems. Say for example, in old days, it was noticed that sellers means those who are selling out through sea, these people were having problem of skin. They were suffering out from skin diseases. It was realized that when they are on sea, they consume maximum non-veg food. Fresh vegetables and fruits are not part of their diet. As a result, they suffer from C vitamin deficiency, which may lead to problem of scurvy and all that. So these are the important thing. Water is required because our 80% body is nearly made up of water only. All chemical processes are going on in our body. They are under chemical reaction. They are also from water. Temperature regulation and all these processes, water is required. So adequate amount of water should be there in our body. So we have to consume good amount of water, but not too much. It is not that one should consume 10 liter water per day. It depends on your requirement and outside temperature conditions also. Because in cold season, we require comparatively less water. In summer or dry summer particularly, we require very good amount of water. So it depends that, but it is required by our body. So all these things are required. Now cellulose, that is fiber, is essential part of food, which will help to clean our alimentary canal. And that's why this fibers, that is cellulose, that is also important. Now, what you have to do? After discussing this chapter, you have to prepare a table. You have to study, you have to make table that each food component, which is good source of that, plus point, that means what is the use of that, if they are in excess, what is the problem, if malnutrition, that means less amount, then what is the problem. So like that, prepare table. In case of vitamin, I have not discussed in detail. There are A, B, C, D and so on. We have to discuss name of vitamin. In case of B, it is B complex. So B1, B2, like that. Every vitamin is having separate name. Say for example, I am talking of vitamin C, but it is having chemical name as ascorbic acid. Where it is produced? Say for example, citrus family fruit, that means lemon, orange, like that. So that source. B vitamin is there from sprout, then from milk, then from curd and all that. Then in our body also, the symbiotic bacteria are staying. They are particularly lactobacillus. They are providing us B complex. So like that, we have to give source of vitamins. D vitamin is synthesized under our skin in presence of morning sunlight. Particularly sun should be less than 15 degree altitude in sky. Then whatever the sunlight is there, that is giving very nice D vitamin under our skin. Now vitamin A, directly obtained from various sources and indirectly also. Say for example, carrots, they are giving us a substance that is called as beta carotene. This beta carotene is converted into vitamin A in human body only. So like that, certain vitamins are having direct source, certain vitamins we are having precursor. Like beta carotene is called as precursor of vitamin A. Then we should not consume vitamins in excess also, because certain fat soluble vitamins like A vitamin, D vitamin, if they are in excess, they are also giving problem, and they are in less quantity, then also they are giving problem. And that's why there is importance of balanced diet. But question is that what is balanced diet? That is not answer given by me. It is depending upon everybody's requirement. The worth that person is doing, and on that basis what is the required thing that is giving you a balanced diet. But balanced diet should have adequate amount. What adequate, forget. I can't give adequate amount, but adequate amount of protein, then carbohydrate, fat, water, minerals and vitamins, along with undigested material, that is cellulose, that is fiber. This is called as adequate diet. So we have to consider these all things and discuss this chapter. So at the end of this chapter, I am going to ask you certain questions. They will be there on screen. So observe that questions and try to give answer. And then after that, we have to solve a paper on basis of this all. After that, we are going to discuss this small test also and paper also. We are going to discuss. Previous test, this test may be somewhat easy. The food is transferred from esophagus to stomach by the process that is called as dash dash. Answer is peristalsis. So this is peristalsis is the process where food is transferred from esophagus to stomach. Bile juice is temporarily stored in, question number 2, on liver, gallbladder. So it is stored in gallbladder. Third, name of enzyme that present in saliva. Two answers are there. Any one is written, it is correct. Number one, as I said, p-tylene. And number two, it is also called as salivary amylase. C vitamin is also known as ascorbic acid. And last, islets of Langerhans are present in dash dash organ. As we discussed, they are present in pancreas. So islets of Langerhans are present in pancreas. So this is the 5 questions we discussed. Just these questions are there that when we are observing multiple lectures, then you will get idea at what point we have to focus. These questions are not covering out entire lecture, but just give you idea that how to focus and what names you have to keep in mind for all that. If your score is 3 or more than 3, then you should proceed. But if it is less than 3, then you have to observe this lecture again. Again appear for a test. If you are getting 3 marks or more than 3 marks, then only proceed. Thanks.